Good afternoon, class. So we'll be looking at or considering a simple topic called colonial education in Nigeria. Now the first thing I want us to get ourselves with is what we call history of colonial administration, that is the genesis or evolution of colonial administration. In our penultimate meeting, we discuss pre-colonial administration in Nigeria, which means the system of government that was in practice before the coming of the colonial master in Nigeria, and the summation of this administrative system in Nigeria before the advent of the colonial master, before we call monarchical system or monarchy system of government. And what is monarchy? The monarchy system of government is a system of government in which a king or queen rules. That's what we call monarchy. So in the Igbo area, it was basically monarchy system, but as a phallus or republican in nature. Then in the Hausa region, it was monarchical system, but absolute monarchy. Then in the Yoruba area, it was monarchical system, but constitutional monarchy. So in pre-colonialism, the colonial master came into Sahara Desert or into West Africa or African continent in the 18th century. So the drama that actually took place in the 19th century was what we call industrial revolution. So industrial revolution took place in the 19th century. That was the period where people moved, or there was a shift in the history of the world from agriculture to what we call office of bureaucracy. That is what happened in the 18th century. So during this period, factories were built, offices were built, companies were built, and as a result of that, in order to feed these factories, in order to make room for raw materials, market and the rest of that, then there was a need, or that prompt the colonial master or the Britain to invade the African land. And because of Nigeria, Nigeria was colonized by a country called Britain. So Britain colonized Nigeria in the 19th century. However, Britain colonized four territories in West Africa. We have Ghana. Ghana got an independent in 1957. We have Nigeria. Nigeria got an independent in 1960 October. We have Gambia. Gambia got an independent in 1961. We have Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone attained an independent in 1961 too. So Britain colonized this for 30. But our focus is on Nigeria. So the history of colonial administration started in the 19th century, prior to the period of industrial revolution in Europe. Then, the reason for colonization, one of the reasons why there was colonization in Africa was what we call raw materials. So the need for raw materials to build these factories or industry, that to feed these factories or feed these industries that were built by the Europeans at that time, led them to colonize Africa. Because it was the cause or the necessity of looking for materials that they were used to produce and finish goods or semi-finished products led to the colonization of Africa. Well, that reason is what we call religious reason. Because the white man believed that African religion, African traditional religion, African beliefs are barbaric, or they were barbaric culture, or myopic culture. So Africa does not possess the best form of religion, according to them. So in order for them, they colonize us and introduce what we call Christian religion into the African world. The other reason for colonization of Africa is what we call Africa.
So market for finished products. Market for finished products. Market for finished products.
So it's another reason, cause for the colonization of Africa. Then also, what type of indirect rule? Indirect rule is a system of government behind the mask. That is, during colonialism, the white man will hide behind the traditional leader and whispers to their ears, hide behind your Obi or Alafeoforyo or Oba or Emir, and then whispers to them and instructs them or influence them, and in return, these traditional rulers will instruct their subjects in line or in consonance with what the white man has whispered to their ear. So that was one of the, that's what we by indirect rule. So it was a system of government in which the colonial master employed to administer the colonized territories in their and this is for indirect rule. We have poor capital. Of course, the British nation was not as rich as the Francophone nation or the France. So, and that's why every month, Lord Frederick Lugard, then, always returned 250 pounds as nomination to European account as profit that he made in Nigeria during colonialism. The other reason for indirect rule is what called paucity of staff, that is inadequate staff. So during that time, few white people visited Nigeria, so there were no enough hands in the administration, in the execution of policies and formulation of policy in the colonized territory. So this form the reasons why they introduce indirect rule. And of course, another reason that is jamming is that indirect rule is very cheap to run. It is less expensive to run. It is not as costly as that of direct rule that the French introduced in the territory they colonized. So this means we call it